Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How are you all children? I hope you all are fine and doing the practice regularly. Children, today we are going to do our next topic, that is angles. Now angles is not a new topic for you all. You all have already learnt about angles in your previous class. Right, you have learnt few types of angles in your class 4. Today we are going to discuss all the types of angles and then we'll see how we measure the angles and how we draw the angles. Okay. Now before that, let's try to understand what we mean by the word angle, or what is an angle. An angle is a figure that is formed when two lines meet at a point. Now if you see on the board, all these figures are the angles, they are the different angles. Okay. Now how an angle is formed? When two lines meet at a point. See, these two lines, they are meeting at a point. Now when these two lines meet at a point, an angle is formed. Okay, so a figure where two lines meet at a point, the angle is formed. Okay, now this point where the two lines are meeting, we call it vertex or corner. Okay, we call it a vertex. And these two lines are the arms of the angle. They are the arms of the angle. So an angle will have two arms. Okay, so two arms and one vertex. So the lines, when they meet at the vertex, an angle is formed. So there are six types of angles. Depending upon the measure of the angles, we have divided them into six types. So which are those six types? They are acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle, straight angle, reflex angle, whole or complete angle. These are the six types of angles. Now these angles are classified or divided depending upon the measure. Okay. Now when we say measure, each angle will have some measure or the value. Okay. So angles, when we measure the angles, there is a unit that we use. That unit is called degree. What is the unit that we use to measure the angles? It is degree. And the symbol for degree is a small circle like this. If you see, here I have used the symbol for degree. Okay, this is the unit that we use to measure the angles, and the symbol is a small circle like this. It is degree. Fine. Now let's see what we mean by acute angle. Now acute angle are the small angles. Okay, they are the small angles. Out of all the six types that we have, acute angles are the small angles. Okay, you know, when children are small, we say that this child is very cute, isn't it? So you can just remember with that word that the small angles are called acute angle. Cute, okay, acute angles. Fine. Now acute angles are the angles that have measure more than 0 degrees, less than 90 degrees. Okay, so the acute angle will measure between 0 degree and 90 degree. Now how do we measure these angles? What do we use to measure the angles? The instrument that we use to measure the angle is a protractor. Okay, you will find this in the geometry box. Now on this protractor you will find there is a scale. Okay, on this scale there are numbers written. We use these numbers or these degrees to measure the angles. I'll show you how we use the protractor later to measure the angles or to draw the angles. How we are going to use the protractor, we'll see later. Okay, so acute angles are the angles that measure more than 0 degree but less than 90 degree. So any measure between 0 and 90 degree, those angles are called acute angles. For example, say 30 degree, it is an acute angle. If an angle is measuring 50 degree, then we say it is an acute angle. Even if an angle measures 89 degree, then also we say that it is an acute angle. So zero, more than 0, less than 90 degree, all the angles we call them acute angles. Okay, they are the small angles. The second type is right angle. Now right angle means the angle will measure exactly 90 degrees. Okay, when the angle measures exactly 90 degrees, we call them right angle. The next type of angle that we have here is obtuse angle. Now what do we mean by obtuse angle? angles that are more than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. Okay, they will be more than 90 degrees, like 91, 92, so on, till less than 180. You can say 179 degree, till 179 degree, all the angles we call them obtuse angle. So, angles that measure more than 90 degrees, less than 180 degree, we call them obtuse angle. Okay. Then the fourth type of angle that I have here is straight angle. Now, you can see the name itself will give you a hint what type of an angle it will be. It will be a straight line. Can you see here? This is an straight angle. Okay, and it will measure exactly 180 degrees. So, the angle that measures 180 degree, we call it straight angle. Okay, I think these four angles you are familiar with, right? In your previous class, you have already learnt about acute angle, right angle, obtuse angle and straight angle. Now, today what you are going to learn new is the reflex angle and whole or complete angle. Now, what do we mean by reflex angle? Now, reflex angle will measure more than 180 degrees, but it will be less than 360 degrees. Now, you see, this is our 180 degree angle. Okay. Now, more than 180 degree, if we start from here 0 to 180, this will be 180 degree. Now, when we say more than 180 degree, this arm will move down. You can see here, the second arm is over here. So, from here to here it was 180 degree, now it has come down, further down. Okay. So, this is more than 180 now. You can see I have written here 230 degrees. So, it is more than 180 degrees. So, these type of angles which are more than 180 degrees, we call them reflex angles. So, the measure of reflex angle will be between 180 degree and 360 degree. Okay, it will be more than 180, less than 360 degrees. So, these type of angles are called reflex angle. The sixth type of angle that I have here is whole or complete. Either we say whole angle or we call them as complete angles. Both means the same. Okay, whole angle or complete angle. That means both the arms of the angles will be overlapping each other. It will be one above the other. That means it will complete one circle. Suppose if I have to talk about this hand, if this hand moves full and comes back to this place, that means it has completed 160 degrees. Okay. So, the angle that measures 160 degrees, one complete round, such type of angles are called whole angle or complete angle. Now, in this angle, you will see that both the arms are above each other. So, you will find just one line. Here, we had two arms. You can see this is one arm and this is the second arm. So, we had two arms over here. We could differentiate between the two arms. But here, both are one above the other. So, we cannot differentiate them. Okay. Now, all the angles, you can see I have given them the names. Like for example, this acute angle, I have named it as A, B, C. Okay. So, we name the angles with capital letters. So, I can say this is angle A, B, C. Here, I have named it as P, Q, R. So, I can say that this is angle P, Q, R. We can also read it as angle R, Q, P. Both the ways we can read the angles. Okay. Same with this angle, I can read it as angle C, B, A also. Okay. Now, here I have named this angle as M, N, O. So, I can read this angle as angle M, N, O, or I can also read it as angle O, N, M. Okay. Same way over here, the angle here is angle R, S, T. We can also read it the other way, angle T, S, R. Okay. I hope you have understood all the six types of angles that are there on the board. Now, we will see how we measure the angles. Now, to measure the angles, we will use protractor. Okay. This is called protractor. This is an instrument that is used to measure the angles. Now, first we will try to understand the protractor, the scale that is there on the protractor. Now, on the protractor, you will find two scales. From 0 to 180 and then again you will have 0 starting from here and coming towards here 180. Now, why do we have two scales over here. There are two scales, 0 starting over here and ending at 180 over here. And then we have another scale which starts 0 over here and ends 180 over here. So why do you think there are two scales on the protractor? If you see, I have drawn the angles on the board. Some angles are facing towards the right side, some are facing towards the left side. Now if you see this angle, it is towards the left side, right? And this angle is facing towards the right side, okay? So this is the reason why we have two different scales on the protractor, okay? Now those angles which are facing towards the left side, we use the scale which is starting 0 at the left side, okay? So if we are drawing an angle which is facing towards the right side, then we use the scale which starts 0 on the right side, okay? So we need to understand how to use the scales of the protractor also. So we'll try to measure the two angles which are there on the board. That is, we'll try to measure this acute angle and obtuse angle and see what is the measure of these two angles. And you can see here both the angles are facing in two different directions. So we'll see how we use the two scales on the protractor, okay? Now first we are going to measure the acute angle. Now when you are measuring the acute angle or any angle, you need to remember that there will be a center point on the protractor. Now this center point of the protractor should be placed on the vertex of the angle, okay? Now this point of the protractor, I'll place it on the vertex of the angle, okay, like this, fine? And the base of the protractor should be on the baseline. This is the baseline of your angle, okay? So both should be in the same line, like this. You can see the protractor is on the center of the protractor is on the vertex, and the baseline of the protractor is on the line of the angle, okay? Now which scale we have to use, that is very important. The zero which is lying on this line, zero of the protractor which is on this line, that scale we will use to measure the angle, okay? So we'll start from the zero which is there on the line. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. My second line is on 60, okay? So the measure of this angle is 60 degrees. From 0 I have started, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. My second line is on 60. So the measure of this angle will be 60 degrees, okay? I hope you have understood how we measure the angle. We have to keep the center of the protractor on the vertex of the angle, and the baseline of the protractor should be on the line of the angle, okay? Start from the zero which is on the line till you reach the next line. You have to see on which number the next line is. That will be the measure of the angle, okay? Now we will try to measure the obtuse angle which is facing towards the right side. Again, the center of the protractor should be on the vertex, and the baseline of the protractor should be on the line of the angle, okay, like this. Fine. The protractor's center is on the vertex, the baseline of the protractor is on the line of the angle. Now the zero which is there on this line, this zero, I have to start from that, the zero which is there on the line. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 130. Now my second arm of the angle is on 130 degrees, okay? Starting from 0, I have gone all the way till 130 degrees. Okay, there will be two scales, but we have to look at the scale where the zero is on the line. That scale we have to consider. So here it is 130 degrees. So the measure of this angle will be 130 degrees. This is how we measure the angles. Okay, so we have to keep the center of the protractor on the vertex, and start from the zero which falls on the baseline of the angle. Okay. Now next we are going to see how we draw an angle. To draw an angle, we will be using the protractor and the scale. Okay, these are the two instruments that we will use to draw an angle. Now I have two angles that we will be drawing today. That is 50 degree angle and 140 degree angle. Now 50 degree, what type of an angle is it? 50 degrees, more than 0, less than 90 degrees. So it is an acute angle. Next we are going to draw 140 degree angle. 140 degree, what type of angle is it? It's an obtuse angle. More than 90 degree, less than 180 degree. So we will draw acute and obtuse angle using the scale and the protractor. Now to draw an acute angle or any angle, first thing what we need to draw is a baseline. So we'll draw a baseline. Okay, name it as XY. Okay, now next we will use the protractor. Now when we are drawing the angle, at that time also we have to keep the center of the protractor on any one point of the baseline. Either I can keep it on X or I can keep it on Y. Okay, now here I will keep it on X. I have kept the center of the protractor on X. My baseline of the protractor is on the baseline of the angle. Okay. Now I have to measure 50 degrees. So I'll start from the zero which is there on the line. Okay. From this zero I have to start and go up to 50 degree. I need a 50 degree angle. So this zero I have to start. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So I'll put a point mark over here at 50 degrees. From 0 I have started till 50 degrees. So I have marked at 50 degrees. Okay. Now we will draw the second arm of the angle. So for that we have to join the vertex with the point that I have marked. Like this. Okay. Now this angle that is formed over here, this will be 50 degrees. Okay. Now I can name it as WXY angle. WXY is a 50 degree angle, which is an acute angle. I hope you have understood how to draw an angle. Okay. Next we will try to draw 140 degree angle. For this the first step is same. We'll draw a baseline. Okay, I have drawn a baseline. We'll name it as, we can name it with any capital letter. I'll name it as MN. Now we have to use the protractor. Keep the protractor on any point, the center of the protractor, either on M or N. Here I will place it on N. Okay. The center of the protractor is on the vertex and the baseline of the protractor is on the line of the angle. Now I have to measure 140 degrees. So I'll start from the zero which is there on the line. Okay, from this zero I will start and I have to come up to 140. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140 is here. So I'll put a mark over here. Okay. The next step, I have to join the vertex with the point that I have marked. Okay, so I have joined the vertex with the point that I have marked and this angle formed over here will be 140 degrees. Okay, I can name it as MNO. So angle MNO is an obtuse angle and it measures 140 degrees. I hope you have understood how to measure the angles and how to draw the angles using the protractor. Now quickly we'll see what all we have discussed today. We started with angle. Angle is a figure formed when two lines meet at a point. The point where the two lines meet we call it a vertex, and the two lines of the angle we call them arms of the angle. There are six types of angles that we have discussed today. They are acute angle. Acute angles are the angles that measure more than 0 degree, less than 90 degrees. The second type of angle that we have here is right angle, which measures 90 degrees. The third type of angle, obtuse angle, they measure more than 90 degree, less than 180 degrees. Then we have straight angles, which measure exactly 180 degrees. The next type of angle that we have discussed is the reflex angle. Now these types of angles measure more than 180 degrees, less than 360 degrees. And the last type of angle that we have discussed is a whole angle, which also known as complete angles. Now these angles measure more exactly 360 degrees. So these are the six types of angles that we have discussed. The unit that we use to measure the angles is degree, and the symbol that we use is a small circle, okay, like this. So the instrument that we use to measure the angles is a protractor. Now we have seen how to use the protractor when we measure or draw the angles. When we are drawing or measuring the angles, we have to keep the center of the protractor on the vertex, and we have to use the scale which of which the zero is on the baseline of the angle. Okay, that scale we have to start using. Okay, children, keep practicing to draw the angles, and inshallah we'll meet very soon with our next topic. Stay at home and be safe. Jazakumullahu khaira. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.